Lag. We all hate it. There's no upside. It's just we all hate it. But over time, the reasons for lag have disappeared, and it's more of just a fact of life.
Oh, this is so laggy.
We've all said it. We haven't thought about why, though. So let's ask. Hi, folks. It's Falcon, and today on Game Ranks, let's ask the question. What causes lag in online video games? The first thing we have to talk about, exactly, is how online games work. Now, we can't go into excruciating detail, so forgive the oversimplification here. There's a few different types of ways that we can send data back and forth. First is client-server, where there's a central server, and all of the people playing the games connect to that central server. Second is peer-to-peer. That's where everybody connects to everybody. Oftentimes, there is a central server peer. There's definitely nuance between these two things. But keep in mind, these are the general forms that online gaming takes in its transmission of information. So let's say, instead of using a centralized server, meaning some computer in some data center somewhere, we're using the more peer-to-peer approach, and one of our peers is acting as the central server. Whatever weaknesses that particular connection has, we will all deal with. So let's say somebody starts up a game on a Wi-Fi connection in, let's say Alaska. I don't know what kind of internet is in Alaska, but I know that it's not as good as pretty much everywhere else. Every other player in the game may have much better connections, but all of their data goes to that person in Alaska and comes back from that person in Alaska. Now, this same dynamic applies to a computer sitting in a data center hosting a game somewhere. The difference is that data centers tend to be set up in a manner that is optimal, in a place that is optimal, by professionals, where I could host a game of blah-de-blah on my own personal laptop in my basement. A game that is hosted on a professionally set up and maintained server will essentially all of the time be connected through Ethernet cords and actual physical wires, contain computers that are specifically built for the kind of workload the game needs. Usually not terribly heavy, it's usually just the transmission of information, but sometimes there are calculations, and that's actually another place where lag may come from. If the game does offload any calculations to the server, and the server ends up having to do too much of it, and we all know what that is like, a computer just gets too much going on and slows down for a minute until it finishes all of it, that will affect every player connected to it. And that is something that is susceptible in a professional server as much as it is a homegrown server, and is almost entirely dependent on how the game structures its calculation. Now, let's say we're using a server that is 100% works just fine, great, set up perfectly, doesn't have any of these issues, has a great connection, all information travels back and forth consistently, and is great. Let's say we've got two players that have varying connections. This is another place where we can see lag form. Let's say there are two conflicting actions that two players take. Like, let's say they both shot a bullet at each other's head. Perfect headshot, no scope, whatever. And let's consider the idea that there is some degree of latency, no matter what, a few milliseconds. It's just the nature of data transmission. It's not possible to have no latency. It is very possible to have very minimal latency, but let's assume one of these players has a 5 millisecond latency and the other has a 10. And on both screens, it appears as though they shot first. This is an example of lag that happens between players through a server. Now, the only way for that really to be resolved is through having the server simply say, well, this is the action we got first. We can't do this any other way. So it may work out that it's possible somebody saw something happen that didn't end up happening. This is usually a source of frustration, but there's not a lot of ways to actually get around this just because of the nature of data transmission. Very small latency is ideal. That's about as far as we're ever going to get. And really the best to hope for is that the server works to sort it out to make sure that there is some layer of consistency. It might piss a couple of people off, but at the same time, there's really no other way to solve these kinds of conflicting actions. And on the note of latency being an inherent thing, just something that is utterly unavoidable, for the most part, it's not noticeable. Lag is usually when latency becomes a problem. And some of it is inherent in the type of game game something is. Let's say a simple kart racing game versus a precision racing game might transmit the same amount of data at the same speed and work pretty much optimally as far as data is concerned, but the precision game might end up appearing to lag on account there is a lot more to perceive. The physics may be more complex. There may be elements of the game that are just much more emphasized than the simple kart racer. And just to note quickly, it's very unlikely you would have a simple kart racer and a complex racing game with intense physics actually transmitting the same amount of data, but that is an included scenario simply for the sake of argument. Simple, goofy game means a few extra milliseconds of lag just don't matter. Intense physics-based neck-and-neck pedal-to-the-floor action might read very differently with the same amount of latency. Now, a lot of this will change if at some point humanity is ever able to create a stable superconductor, and aside from that, reproduce it at low cost or no cost. But that's a situation that would do a lot more than just make video games a lot better. It would make the world a lot better. And in some respects, you can even think of the idea that lag is kind of reflective of a physical law that we're always going to have to deal with. The idea of electrical resistance. The closer you get to solving that conundrum, the closer you get to having a perfect lag-free online experience. What's the laggiest or least laggy game you have ever played? Leave us a comment, let us know what you think. And if you like this video, please click like. If you're not subscribed, now's of course a great time to do so. We upload brand new videos every day of the week, and the best way to see them first is of course a subscription. So click subscribe, and don't forget to click the notification bell. As always, we thank you very much for watching this video. I'm Falcon, you can follow me on Twitter @FalconTheHero, and we'll see you next time, right here on GameRanks.